how your career kind of started. We look at kind of a turning point like around 1960, where it seems to me you you've mentioned that you saw John Cassavetes' Shadows, and just purely in the way that he makes his films, that in that improvised way.
Well, I think that's true, and I think what I would say about 1960 is that at the tender age of 17, what I was in 1960, I escaped to London. Now, up to that time, I'd never seen a film that wasn't in English. Apart from that hideous short Le Ballon Rouge, which is horrible, sentimental. I thought you might say that. Yeah, we went to the pictures all the time, as much as they let us, you know. Without being irrelevant or nostalgic, it is great to be in a 1915 or whatever this is cinema, because when I grew up in Salford and North Manchester, you could, from our house, you could walk to 14 different cinemas. That's without going into town to the big Gaumont and Odeon and things in Manchester. And so, you know, like, again, my contemporaries in the audience will remember that you could see there were always two films in every programme. The programme was changed in the middle of the week. There was a different programme on Sundays. And there were actually cinemas that showed anything that they could get their hands on. It wasn't just the releases. So, and since we're talking about the late 40s and the 50s, I mean, there were old prints kicking around from before the war. So there were all kinds of stuff. So I saw a lot of cinema. Plus, there were, of course, those wonderful news theatres that showed shorts and Laurel and Hardy and Charlie Chaplin and weird things about kangaroos boxing and Pathé News. And they'd run for an hour and you could stay there all day if you wanted to. Plus, you know, I had an uncle that showed 8mm things with his projector upstairs in the spare room, and so, and then there was television, of course. In one form or another, I saw all kinds of movies, which again, we who are contemporaries did, but I never saw a film that wasn't a British or a Hollywood movie.
Yeah.
So you talk about 1960. I mean, down I went to London to be trained as an actor at Robbins. And there was not only Cassavetes, that film Shadows, which was the first of his films, and you did gather that somehow it had been improvised. But there was world cinema. There were the French, Bergman, there was the Italian, Russians, the Japanese, it all was an explosion and an amazing discovery. And of course, that time coincided with the Nouvelle Vague, was great French, Truffaut, Godard, and so on. And that was really the blast, discovering